Now, some application which are related to the questions on simple and compound interest. Now, when we study this topic long time back in the school days, you will agree to the fact that most of the cases we used to have the examples of only simple interest and compound interest formula. We used to say that it is P into R into T by 100, or calculating the amount for compound interest, which is P into 1 plus R by 100 to the power N. But now the companies are asking questions where you can apply a very simple logic for it. I'll just draw a simple table for this. Please try to understand. You have a simple interest and you have a compound interest. All right. Now the point is, at the end of the first year, what I know, I use three major terms. P, that is a principal. It can also be called as a present value. Second term is R, which is rate of interest. And that rate of interest is always given as per annum, even if it is mentioned or not mentioned in the question. Third duration is time, which is always given in years. Considering these three variables, simple interest says what? At the end of first year, principal amount is P, rate of interest is R, so it is P into R by 100. Whereas compound interest is also P into R by 100. At the end of the second year, this will remain P, this will be PR by 100. This will be PR by 100, matlab jo pehle saal interest mila hai wo, plus us interest pe bhi interest milega R percent ka. When we get interest on interest, the word is used as compounding. So try to understand, there is no need to again by heart the formulas. It is a very simple logic. If you are getting an interest on interest, the word is used as compounding. Whereas at the end of the third year, this will remain PR by 100. This PR by 100, matlab jo pehle saal mila, dusre saal mila, wo as it is rahega. PR by 100. This is PR square by 100 square. And on this PR square by 100 square, you will get again a R percent ka interest. When you are getting this interest on interest on interest, the amount which is used is what we call it as the compounding. In majority of the questions, when you are solving, use these two fundamental rules. Number one, simple interest at the end of every year remains the same. It does not change. Second, simple and compound interest at the end of first year remains the same. Third, compound interest at the end of every year keeps on increasing. So if I read this question, it says a certain sum of money doubles in 3 years under SI at a certain rate of interest. In how many years will it become 5 times itself at the same rate of interest? All right. So in how many years will it become 5 times itself? There is no need to use any formula. Simple example, I considered P as 100. All right. Certain sum of money doubles. Matlab 100 ko kitna banana hai? 200 banana hai. 200 will be your amount. 100 ko 200 banana hai. Matlab 100 ke upar mujhe 100 rupees ka interest chahiye. 100 pay 100 rupees ka interest mujhe kitne saal mein milega? 3 saal mein milega. Right. That's what the question says. Certain sum of money doubles in 3 years. Now, what I want is, it says, in how many years will it become 5 times itself? 100 ko kitna banana hai? 500. Interest kitna? 400. 100 rupay pe 400 ka interest. 100 pe 400 ka interest. 100 rupay ka interest 3 saal mein. 100 rupay ka interest 3 saal mein. To 400 ka kitne saal mein? Which is as good as what? 12 years. If you are getting 100 rupees interest in 3 years, so in how many years you will get an interest of 400 rupees, and that will happen in how many years? 12 years. Why we are able to do it? Because we know one thing, simple interest at the end of every year remains the same. It does not change. So considering this application, we can say 100 rupees of interest in 3 years. So 400 rupees of interest can be obtained in 12 years. So the correct answer becomes what? 12 years. It's fine. Now let's see one more example of simple and compound interest considering the part of CI. It says a certain sum of money doubles in 3 years under CI at a certain rate of interest. In how many years will it become 16 times itself at the same rate of interest? Earlier in the previous example, we have taken the part of simple interest. Now we'll try to take up the part of compound interest. What we know is we can say amount is always written as P into 1 plus r by 100 to the power n. I have invested p, it should double, it means it should become 2p. In how many years it should happen? It is happening in how many years? 3 years. So p gets cancelled. Simply I can say 1 plus r by 100 to the power 3 is equal to 2. Alright, that's what I interpret by the first line. Now it says in how many years will it become 16 times itself? So I have to make it 16 times. So I invest p, I want 16 times p. In how many years it can happen? Let it be n. Alright, so again your p terms gets cancelled. So 1 plus r by 100 to the power n is equal to 16. Now the problem with the question terms in terms of the language, the easier part is, you know the rate of interest is what? Same. Because the rate of interest is same, I can simply say 1 plus r by 100 can be substituted as capital R. Alright, to make the language easier, I can say r cube is equal to 2 and r to the power n is equal to 16. So r cube is equal to 2, which means r to the power n is equal to 16. What will happen is, you can simply say r to the power n is equal to 16. This 16 is nothing but 2 to the power 4. So 2, this 2 that is a base, is given as r cube. Power is 4. So this 2 is substituted by r cube and this power 4 remains as it is. So r to the power n is equal to r to the power 12. Bases are same. Powers can be equated. So n is equal to how much? 12. When I say n is equal to 12, so in how many years will it become 16 times itself at the same rate of interest? And that is going to happen in how many years? 12 years. So this is a general example of making the question simple, and somehow none of the calculative questions, you will find it in the papers, which are wasting a lot of time in terms of finding this simple or compounding rate of interest. It's fine. Take up one more example. It says the ratio of SI to CI for 2 years on the same rate and same principle is 10 is to 11. What is the rate of interest? Now, it is again talking about a comparative term of SI to CI. Just we discussed in the part of simple and compound interest that the learning observation was simple interest at the end of every year remains the same. It does not change. Whereas we can say that in case of compound interest, in every year it changes. And this ratio in the problem of SI to CI is given to you as 10 is to 11. So I can say 10 rupees or 10x, whatever value is comfortable. So if I can say 10 rupees of interest, I can get in 2 years. So at the end of first year as well as the second year, it will become what? 5 each. I know one thing, simple and compound interest at the end of first year remains the same. So if this is 5, this is also 5. And total compound interest for 2 years is 11. So on the first year it is 5. So second year it will become 6. So can I say this won't help us to get the rate of interest? But here if you try to see, 5 is becoming 6. So on 5 rupees, you get an interest of 1 rupee. And interest of 1 rupee is obtained on 5. So 1 on 5 multiplied by 100, which is as good as what? 20%. So compound interest for 2 years will be as good as 20%. Alright, and that will be the exact rate of interest that is obtained. Because we know one thing, simple interest at the end of every year remains the same. It's clear? Let's see the next example